Hello everybody, it is very nice to meet you again. I am Dr. Prince, Department of English. Once again, it is very happy to see you through the video. And today, we are going to discuss about how English plays a vital role. Why English is dominating throughout the world. And how is it possible to all the human beings to get well-versed or master in English. So, I have chosen a title called Acquisition of English as a Foreign Language and or a second language. What do you mean by acquisition? Acquisition is nothing but learning a language. So, being the other part of England, America, Australia, English is considered as a second language. Being India is a beautiful nation and so many people are good in English because they are well versed in the particular language. So, how is it possible for all the people to get master over the particular language? The first step is you have to learning is a intellectual process, which means it needs some intellectual ability. You have to understand the concept. That is a word I have used called cognition. Cognition is nothing but you have to understand each and every concept how you have to learn a particular language. Learning, as I have said already, learning is an intellectual process. Intellectual is nothing but it needs knowledge. You need in-depth knowledge in learning a language. Since English is so many, there is a saying that so many people felt very hard to speak in English. They will blab something, they will be search of words. So how is it very easy to speak English means first thing is you have to sit and understand the concept. For that you need an intellectual ability, which means you should sit and you have to concentrate each and every paragraph what has been dealt in that particular paragraph. For that, learning is a process depends upon practical approach. What can be called as practical approach? Practical approach is nothing but you need a practice. You have to practice daily. So how you have to practice daily in acquiring a language? So if you are practicing daily, you may have a question that is it possible to speak very fluently? I assure you that if you practice daily in your house or wherever you practice, easily you can get a master in particular language. Either it can be called as English or any languages. If you are daily practicing any language, easily you can be a master. So how you have to get practice daily? For that I have to talk about four different skills. The first one is listening, speaking, reading and writing. So how is it possible to get connected towards all these four beautiful skills? So what can be called as listening? Listening is nothing but how a child used to speak in the first mother tongue. So the first step of a child is the child used to think and listen and observe the mother very keenly and minutely. So after listening and observing the words of mother, it used to start a new word, or to start a beginning of a new word will be beautifully given by the children. So the first step is you have to listen to the practical sentences or the native speaking. If you are listening to the native speakers, it will be very automatically, I assure you that you can speak very neat, beautiful English. For that, you have to sit and you have to listen and you have to observe how the pronunciation is, how the accent is, how the dialogue is, how they are giving intonation, stress and pause. If you are going on listening and observing these things, I assure you, you can be a master in English. The second step is, how is it possible to speak? For that, you have to take the process called imitation. So what can be called as imitation? Imitation is nothing but you have to imitate the native speaker, their how their pronunciation is. If you are minutely observing and listening the imitation skill, you can easily speak the language. So the third process is reading. After completing these two processes, the third one is a very very important process. You have to read lot. You have to come across so many vocabularies and you should have all the vocabularies in your mind and you should know where I have to use the vocabularies. So say the first process is listen and observe, and the second one is you have to speak, and third one is reading. So when you will read, you should have the keen interest. You should have all kind of interest in your heart. If you are going on reading out of interest, you will be a master in that particular language. So the final process is writing process, which so many of you can have an idea that writing is a very hard process. I can sit and write, but I could not write anything. I am searching of words, what kind of words I have to use, I don't know. So the simple thing is, all kind of these three steps will make you to have a beautiful writing about any kind of ideas. For that, you have to have some kind of creative process. Creative process is nothing but you have to read the books and you have to connect with the words. You should be having something in your mind and you have to memorize the vocabularies, and you should know where I have to use it and how I have to use a particular word. If you follow these four processes, automatically you can learn English, whether it can be a foreign language or second language. One day or other, you will be a master. Thank you so much. We can meet you in the next video. Thank you.